Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. Chemistry in Everyday Life, Revision, Class 3. So first read that instructions written on the board. All this is the theoretical topic. Just by reading the topic and by understanding the concept, whatever given in the textbook, you can easily understand if you are reading in a proper manner. And in this chapter, we can come across through so many number of medical terminologies. If you want to know what are the meanings of those medical terminologies, simply you can Google it in the Chrome or in the Safari. There you will find the Wikipedias as well as images. For example, if I am saying beriberi, that is a disease. Xerothalmia, that is a disease. Rickets, that is a disease. So to know about these type of medical terminologies, just I am requesting you all, just Google them and try to find their information and images. Being online classes, it is not easy to explain each and everything through the online. Sorry to say like this, please cooperate with me. Thank you, one and all. Yes, I'm going to share the screen. Yes, on the screen you are seeing today's topic. Just yesterday we started the discussion. Yesterday we started the discussion about this one, that is tranquilizers. Tranquilizers. Yes. What are meant by tranquilizers? Tranquilizers, first of all, they are the class of neurologically active drugs. That means these drugs are affecting the nervous system. So they are called as neurologically active drugs. And one of the category of neurologically active drugs is tranquilizers. Yes. Coming to the definition of tranquilizers. Tranquilizers, see here, tranquilizers are a class of chemical compounds used for the treatment of stress. To reduce the stress, we are using the drugs. So stress reducing drugs, that are the tranquilizers. Stress, where it is going to build up? The stress is going to build up in our brain. Brain is containing so many nerves. So all those nerves which are going to have the strain, that is called as stress, to remove that stress, we are using the drugs, that are called as tranquilizers. So tranquilizers are a class of chemical compounds used for the treatment of stress and mild or even severe mental diseases. Whenever we are not able to overcome the stress, when we are not able to overcome the stress, finally one day that person becomes mentally diseased, mentally disturbed person. So whether it may be mild in condition or it may be a severe condition of a mental disease, to recover that person from that mental disease, again the drugs used, they are called as tranquilizers. So simply we can say that tranquilizers are a class of chemical compounds which are used to treat the stress and which is used to recover a person from the mental disease. And the tranquilizers can also be used to relieve the anxiety. Anxiety. Some persons are very anxious. When we are going to do a new thing, when we are going to approach a new person, then some persons will feel some anxiety. So to reduce that anxiety also, the drugs used are called as tranquilizers. And stress, irritability, excitement, all these can be reduced. And by taking these drugs, we feel well-being, well-being. So to feel the well-being, the drugs whatever used are called as tranquilizers. They are going to reduce our stress. They are going to reveal our anxiety. They are going to reduce our anxiety. The examples for tranquilizers. So before going to the examples of tranquilizers, if we take these type of drugs, generally they cause to producing of sleep. The tranquilizers cause to producing of sleep. See here, sleeping pills. when we are in stress, generally that persons are not getting a proper sleep. So to get the proper sleep, when that person is going to approach the doctor is going to prescribe sleeping pills. But the sleeping pills are very dangerous. We should not use the sleeping pill to get a proper sleep. With the help of doctor's prescription only, we have to use when we are having overstressed, right? So sleeping pills are also the class of compounds that are the tranquilizers. They are going to produce a good sleep. As a result, the stress in our brain is going to get reduced. Then we will feel being very happy. That is well-being, well-being. And examples for tranquilizers. Noradrenaline is an example of tranquilizer. Is one of the neurotransmitters that plays an important role in mood changing. From bad mood to good mood, from bad mood to good mood, to change the mood, then we are using this one, noradrenaline. This is a drug. This is an example of tranquilizer. Yes, all it is the theory. Just by reading and by understanding, you can easily solve the MCQs. No need of explanation of exercise 1, exercise 2, exercise 3. Just by reading the textbook properly and by understanding each and every word properly, you can solve each and every MCQ. Please cooperate with me, right? So noradrenaline is an example of tranquilizer. And one more example. Yes, here it is, another type of one. Antidepressant drugs. Anti to depressant. Depressed person means, what is meant by a depressed person? That is overstressed person. A depressed person means a overstressed person. So to reduce the stress, what we are using? Tranquilizer. They are going to reduce the stress. They are going to reduce the depression. That type of compounds are also called as antidepressant drugs. So here, noradrenaline. What the noradrenaline is going to do? These drugs inhibit the enzyme which catalyzes the degradation of noradrenaline. When we are using the antidepressant drugs, that antidepressant drugs are going to act on noradrenaline, then the stress in our body or in the brain is going to be get reduced. Yes, I'm going to show you the diagram, structure of the molecules. And some more examples for tranquilizers or the antidepressant drugs. Iproniazid. Here, the spelling and the pronunciation is little bit difficulty because these are the new words to all of us. Please read properly and pronounce properly. Iproniazid. Once again, iproniazid and phenylzine. Phenylzine. Iproniazid and phenylzine. These are the examples of tranquilizers. In the CET level or in the NEET level, just simply they give four options. The question given as, which of the following is an example of tranquilizer? Just you have to remember only. Here there is no formulas are there, no reaction is there, nothing is there. Just by reading the concept, by keeping it in your brain, then simply you can answer it. So to keep in the brain, you have to practice regularly. A regular practice only gives the success. A regular practice only gives the success. Already the NTA, National Testing Academy, NTA, National Testing Academy, that is going to conduct JEE, Joint Entrance Examination for mains and advanced, and NEET examinations, NEET. Both the examinations are conducting by NTA, National Testing Academy. Already yesterday, NTA announced the dates for JEE examination, but later they were cancelled. Of course, soon we have to face the exam, whether it may be JEE or it may be NEET. So be prepared. Do your practice every day, then only you will get succeed. Otherwise, you are going to waste your time. You will lose a year of your education. Please don't do like that. Please practice each and every topic and MCQs every day. Right? Coming to the point, tranquilizers. Examples for tranquilizers, iproniazid. This is a structure, iproniazid. If you say this iproniazid structure, you can find a single bond NH, single bond C double bond O. This is the group. Single bond NH, single bond C double bond O group. That is called as amide functional group. Amide. Single bond NH, single bond C double bond O is called as amide functional group. And here, double bond N with single bond. This is the nitrosen. Whenever a nitrosen is there, that is indicating it is the amine functional group. So iproniazid is having amine group. This is the tertiary amine group. And here, amide group is also there. This type of points are the key points for a CET or NEET or JEE. So just by reading the concept only, you can't get the marks. You have to analyze the given examples. You have to analyze the examples. So once again, iproniazid is containing amide group and a tertiary amine group. Here, again, NH group is there. NH group stands for secondary amine group. And one more example is phenylzine. Phenylzine. This is the structure given. Here you can see NH2. NH2 is indicating primary amine group. NH is indicating secondary amine group. Right? So once again, this is about tranquilizers. Tranquilizers means they are a class of chemical compounds which are used for the treatment of stress and which are used to cure the mental diseases. And the tranquilizers can relieve the anxieties. The tranquilizers can reduce the stress. The tranquilizers can reduce the irritability. In some situations, we feel irritated. So to reduce that irritability also, we are using the tranquilizers and to reduce the excitement. Right? Just read it and try to remember in your brain. And some more examples for tranquilizers. Some more examples for tranquilizers. Chlorodiazepoxide. Chlorodiazepoxide. And meprobamate. Meprobamate. Are relatively mild tranquilizers. These are not having more effect. These are having only less effect. Less effect. Then they are said to be as mild tranquilizers. These are suitable for relieving tensions. So examples for mild tranquilizers are Equanil, which is used in controlling of depression and which is used to reduce the hypertension. That is high BP. To reduce the hypertension and to reduce the depression, the chemical substance used is Equanil. That is a drug. That is an example of mild tranquilizer. Here all the structures are given. Just in your textbook, see the structures. Try to remember the functional groups present in those drugs. And the next one is, yes, one more is given here. Derivatives of barbutyric acids. The derivatives of barbutyric acids. Ic acid is given here. Ic acid means oic acid. Oic acid. That is the derivative of carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acid means a single bond COOH group. So barbutyric acids, derivatives of barbutyric acids like veranol, amytal, nimbutal, luminol, and secanol. All these are also the examples of tranquilizers. And all these are coming from barbutyric acid. Barbutyric acid. So these are called as derivatives of barbutyric acid. Simply they are called as barbutyrates. Just remember this word. Just remember this word. No need to remember any of the structures. Barbutyrates. There are examples of tranquilizers. Just simply you can remember this one only. Once again, barbutyrates are the examples of tranquilizers. What are the examples of barbutyrate means? Again, you have to remember. These are veranol, amytal, nimbutal, luminol and secanol, all these are the examples of barbiturates. These are the examples of tranquilizers. And one more, barbiturates are hypnotic in nature. All of you know about hypnotism. When any person is going to hypnotize other person, that person who is going to do the hypnotism, he is going to give some food to you. Chocolate or biscuit or laddu or a bajji, that is mirchi, whatever it may be, some food is going to be given to you. When you are going to eat that material, food, then that person is going to hypnotize you. What that food is going to contain means, that food, what we are going to eat is going to contain hypnotic drug. So barbiturates, they are acting as hypnotic drugs. That means slowly our brain is going to be in a dull mood. That means our thoughts in our brain is going to be get reduced. Our stress in our mind is going to be get reduced. Slowly we will feel sleepy. When we are in a little bit sleepy mode, whatever the question the person is going to ask, we are going to give the truth answer, but not the false answer. We are going to say only the truth, but not false. So to get the truth from the criminals, particularly from the criminals, to get the truth, the police people is going to hypnotize the criminals by giving the food that is containing the hypnotic drugs. Barbiturates are the examples of hypnotic drugs. Examples for barbiturates are veranol, amitol, nembutol, luminol, and secanol. All these are the examples of barbiturates. They are the hypnotic drugs and they are the class of tranquilizers. And tranquilizers are a class of neurologically active drugs. Means the drugs which are acting on the nervous system, they are called as neurologically active drugs. Tranquilizers is a class of neurologically active drugs. In the tranquilizers, antidepressants are also there. They are also the tranquilizers. And here is the thing. Hypnotic drugs are there. They are also the examples of tranquilizers. Right? Just see these structures. The structure of veranol, valium, serotonin, all these are given. Right, next one is, yes, this is the most important topic in this chapter. Analgesics. See this heading? Analgesics. Yes, analgesics means, generally when we are having any body pain or headache, that is a mild pain. But when any person is having the cancer, whether it may be a lung cancer, or it may be a kidney cancer, or it may be a blood cancer, any of the cancer is there, that person suffers with a heavy pain, severe pain. So pain is two types. One is the mild pain, second one is the severe pain. To reduce the pain in our body, we are going to use the drug that is called as analgesic. Once again, the drug what is used to reduce the pain in the body is called as analgesic. Here a word is given. Analgesics reduce or abolish. Abolish means remove. Analgesics reduces or removes the pain without causing impairment of consciousness. Once again, the analgesics reduces or removes the pain without causing impairment of consciousness. What is meant by impairment of consciousness? Suppose to reduce the body pain, suppose I am going to take either paracetamol or ibuprofen. Generally it is called as brufen. In our regular language, it is called as brufen. But the chemical name is ibuprofen. So once again, to reduce our body pains, when we are going to take either paracetamol or ibuprofen, we are not confused. By taking the drug, we are not having any confusion. There is no confusion in our brain. just the body pains are going to get reduced. So these analgesics are the drugs that are going to reduce or remove the pain without causing impairment of consciousness and mental confusion. They don't cause to mental confusion. Analgesics, they don't cause to mental confusion and incoordination. What is meant by incoordination? Suppose when I am going to travel on my bike in a road, I am going to travel on my bike in a road, some other person is coming in the opposite way. When I take some drug, when my brain is going to be unconscious during the driving, for example, when I am drunken, that means when I am taken the alcohol and I am going to drive and the opposite person is coming on my way, generally the brain is not giving a proper signal. That is unconsciousness. Then what is going to happen? Collision is going to happen. That is the unconsciousness of the brain. But when we are going to take the analgesics, they are not causing to any confusion, they are not causing to any impairment, they are not causing to any inconsciousness or unconsciousness, they are not causing to mental confusion. Just simply, the drugs, they are going to reduce the body pain or they are going to remove the body pain without causing any disturbance, without causing any disturbance on the nervous system. So this type of drugs are called as analgesics. And again, these analgesics are classified into two types. Our body is having two types of pains. One is a normal pain, that is a mild pain. And second one is a severe pain. Normal pain is due to, whether it may be headache or body pains or any stomach ache like that, they are the mild pains. But the cancer pains are severe pains. So to reduce the mild pains, we are using non-narcotic analgesics. Just on the screen, you can see the two classifications. The first classification is non-narcotic analgesics. They are called as non-addictive drugs. Once again, non-narcotic analgesics. They are also known as non-addictive drugs. Second one is narcotic drugs. Narcotic drugs. First, coming to the non-narcotic drugs. They are also called as non-addictive drugs. Non-addictive means they are having no addictive property. The non-addictive drugs, they are not having addictive property. For example, if we are having the headache, when I am living in my place, that is in Nellore, and I went to some medical shop and I asked for a tablet to reduce my headache. That person gave me some tablet and I took that one and I absorbed that one into my body. After some time, my headache is going to get reduced. And after some days, when I came to Ballari, and due to some reasons, again I'm having the headache. Now I went to one more medical shop in the Ballari and I asked for some tablet to reduce my headache. But here in this Ballari, that person, medical shop person, gave me a different tablet. Again, I am consuming that one. My headache is reduced. That means here, whenever I am in Nellore, a person gave me a tablet. Here in Ballari, a person is gave me a tablet. They are not having the same chemical composition. But they are able to reduce the same pain. So I am not addictive to this drug, or I am not addicted to that drug. But some drugs are there, when we have to take that medicine only, then only the body pains are going to be reduced. Then only the pain is going to be reduced by taking only particular drugs. Such type of drugs are called as addictive drugs. They are called as narcotic drugs. Non-addictive drugs are called as non-narcotic analgesics. So just say this one. Okay, somebody is texting. Okay, fine. So first of all, the topic is analgesics. What is meant by analgesic? They are the drugs which are used to reduce or abolish pain without causing impairment of consciousness or without causing mental confusion or without causing incoordination or paralysis or some other disturbance of nervous system, just they simply reduce the pain. They are called as analgesics. They are classified into two types. First one, non-narcotic analgesics, known as non-addictive drugs. The second one, narcotic drugs, they are called as addictive drugs. Sir, video is getting stuck. Here, my video is coming very clear to me. Remaining students, please text me, ma, whether my video is coming clearly or not. Gautam is saying that video is getting stuck. Please, remaining students, please respond. Is my video is coming clear? Is my video is coming clear? Is my video is coming clear? Okay, fine. So for some students only, it is having some problem. That means in your area, the network, there is a problem in your network. I think so. So most of the students are texting that the video and audio is very clear. So just move your place. Just move your mobile to other place. Then you will get the proper video and audio. Right, thank you. Just coming to the point here. So we are discussing about the analgesics. They are classified into two types. The first one is non-narcotic analgesics. They are non-addictive in nature. Non-addictive in nature. Example is aspirin. Aspirin and paracetamol. All of you know about aspirin. Whenever a person is going to suffer with heart pain, if a person is having excess of cholesterol in the heart walls, then the blood pumping is going to be a different manner to the heart. Then such person is going to feel some pain in the heart. So there is a probability of heart attack for those persons who are suffering with excess cholesterol. So to avoid the probability of attacking of heart strokes, aspirin is the drug used for the heart patients. Aspirin. In the last classes also we discussed about aspirin. And I already explained the preparation of aspirin. See this one? This is the structure of aspirin. Yes, just by seeing only benzene ring with single bond COOH. Once again, only benzene ring with single bond COOH is called as benzoic acid. Benzoic acid. This is the ortho position. When the ortho position is having single bond OH, suppose the ortho position is having single bond OH, that is called as 2-hydroxybenzoic acid. 2-hydroxybenzoic acid is called as salicylic acid. Once again, if the second position here is having single bond OH, now the compound is called as 2-hydroxybenzoic acid, known as salicylic acid. Where here hydrogen is going to be replaced with a single bond C double bond O, single bond CH3, single bond C double bond O, single bond CH3. This is called as acetyl group. Acetyl group. Now CH3 single bond C double bond O, single bond O, single bond. This total group is called as acetate. Acetate. In this acetate, single bond C double bond O, single bond O, single bond is there. This group is called as ester group. This group is called as ester group, whereas this group is called as carboxylic acid group. So the ortho position is subjected to acetylation in salicylic acid. Then we are going to get ortho acetyl. Here I didn't mention the ortho. We have to write O minus, not the O minus, O hyphen. That is ortho acetyl salicylic acid. It is the IUPAC name of the compound, and its common name is aspirin. So aspirin is going to reduce the pain without causing unconsciousness, without causing impairment, right? And without affecting the nervous system, just it is going to reduce the pain. So aspirin is an example of non-narcotic analgesic or non-narcotic drug or non-addictive drug. And one more example is paracetamol. Just now I explained this one. Paracetamol is also an example of non-narcotic or non-addictive drug. Yes, aspirin. Aspirin is the most familiar example. And aspirin inhibits means stops. The aspirin stops the synthesis of chemicals known as prostaglandins. Remember the word? Prostaglandins. So the chemical prostaglandin is going to be produced. This production of prostaglandin was stopped by aspirin. As a result, when the prostaglandin's release is going to be reduced, the pain in the heart walls, the pain in the heart vessels is going to be reduced. So that is the use of aspirin, right? And one more thing, antipyretics. Pyro means heat. To reduce the heat. Here heat means a temperature actually. When we are having the fever, our body becomes heat and heat and heat. So to reduce the temperature of our body, we are taking the medicine that is called as antipyretic. Anti means against. Pyro means heat. Once again, anti means opposite. Pyro means heat. The drug which is against to heat, or the drug which is going to reduce the temperature of the body, such type of drugs are called as antipyretics. Whenever we are having the fever, when we are suffering with fever, our body becomes dizzy and we will feel some pain in our body. So to reduce the temperature of the body and to reduce the pain of the body, we are using the medicine that is the paracetamol. So the paracetamol is an example of tranquilizer. The paracetamol is an example of non-narcotic drug. The paracetamol is an example of non-addictive drug. There is no addiction to the paracetamol. So paracetamol is an example of non-addictive drug, and the paracetamol is going to reduce the temperature of the body. As a result, paracetamol is also known as antipyretic drug. So we can say that antipyretic drugs are the examples of tranquilizers. Once again, antipyretic drugs are the examples of tranquilizers. So antipyretics are the examples of non-narcotic drugs, or they are also known as non-addictive drugs. So this is about non-addictive or non-narcotic drugs. And one more thing, generally some persons feel chest pain. They may feel that they are going to have heart attack. Just they feel like that. Then immediately they are going to take aspirin. If we take the aspirin excess, what will happen means, actually the nature of aspirin tablet is to dilute, to decrease the density of the blood. That means the blood is going to decrease its thickness. The blood is going to be thin. So to become the blood thin, we are using the aspirin. Then the blood is going to be easily pumping to the heart walls when the cholesterol is there in the heart. But some persons, when they are having the chest pain, just they feel that they are going to soon attacked by heart stroke. That's why they are going to take aspirin directly without prescription of the doctor. When we are going to take the aspirin excess without the prescription of the doctor, in our body the blood becomes very diluted. Whenever we met with any accident, generally after some time, whenever cut is happened here, suppose here some cut is happened, some wound is happened, the blood is going to bleed. But after 5 minutes or 10 minutes, the blood should be clotted. But when we are using aspirin excess, the blood never going to be clotted. The blood is going to continuously bleed. So finally, the blood in our body is going to come out of the cells. The cells are going to lose the energy. The BP, blood pressure of our body is going to get slowly reduces. The heart working function is going to be stopped. Finally, that causes to death. When we are going to meet with an accident, when the blood bleeding is going to happen continuously. Why the bleeding is going to happen continuously? Because that person is taking the aspirin excess. So we should not use the drugs, or we should not use the medicines without the prescription of the doctors, and we should not use the medicines in excess quantities or excess doses. So that is all about non-narcotic drugs. And one more is there, narcotic drugs. The time is very less. Tomorrow we will discuss this one, narcotic drugs. Otherwise, just by reading that one, you can understand that one. Try to read yourself. Otherwise, from tomorrow onwards, I will send you the recorded videos. Because this is only the last live class for this week. So from tomorrow onwards, just I am going to upload the recorded videos into my YouTube channel. If you require, you have to go through the YouTube channel. You have to check them. You have to watch them. Yes, give your response in the chat box. Text me the response. Text me your response. Again, I'm requesting you all, those who didn't paid even a single rupee to the college as your first term or second term fee, I request you all, please come to the college. Please discuss with our principal madam about paying your fee. Otherwise, please come to the college, take your TC, apply for your TC. Thank you, one and all. Stay home, stay safe. Have a nice day. This is your chemistry lecturer, Sesdin Naidu, signing off.